We are talking about this thing, and we are looking at this is the distance, okay? And this is the time, and I have a graph going here and then going here. Now, first tell me AB. AB, what do you think? Is the car, let's say it's a story of a car, is the car moving? The distance is going up. Is the car moving?
Yeah.
Yeah. Someone mentioned about acceleration. Can I find acceleration here?
No.
Okay, cannot. But I can find something else.
Speed.
How do I find speed? Speed equals to distance over time. Now, if I focus on the graph itself, how distance means the vertical, right? The vertical part, this part, right? And horizontal is the time, right? So this is the horizontal. What am I finding? When I take the red divided by the green, area of the graph wrong. Speed, yes, I'm finding speed, and speed is distance over time. Very good. I'm trying hard not to tell you the word, and I want you to link it to gradient of distance time graph. This is a gradient. Okay, now this is a very important story because very easily we can talk about BC. BC is what? No distance increase. No distance increase means the particle is stopped. So particle is not moving. Alright. And then we say that this one, the speed is equals to 0 cm per second. Okay, now let's look at the second graph. Still copying?
No.
Anyway, you can refer to the YouTube. Go and copy there. Okay, now next one. These two graphs, I'm going to explain what's the difference. Now, the same thing is both graphs, it is going up. Okay, both graphs going up. That means the distance is increasing. Yeah, but if I were to zoom in, let me zoom to the first one. Now, I am interested in the gradient. Can you tell me gradient equals to what? The speed, agree? Equals to the rate, agree? And how do I find distance or speed on a curve? A T word. Tangent. I need to draw a tangent. So if I can draw tangent, I will try and draw tangent across every point. And can you describe to me, this one means my tangent is increasing or my tangent is decreasing?
Increasing.
How many of you don't agree? Oh, agree, increasing. That means my gradient is increasing. All agree? That means what I can conclude from this is, I bring down, this one is the rate or the speed, both same word. The rate is increasing at a increasing rate. Can I follow? Nobody who is confused about the increasing at an increasing rate? Nobody. Okay. Then we go on to the story first. Look at the next one. The one on the far right. This one. Look at this one. Now, same thing. I look at the gradient. What happened to the gradient?
Decreasing,
correct?
Yeah, increasing.
Okay. So which means the rate is still increasing, but at a decreasing rate. Okay. Now maybe I give you some number. So because we work very well with number, okay? We work very well with number. So I'm going to write down a few things. So I try. So this is time 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. This is A. And I have B. I have C. Okay, I'm going to zoom out even further. Alright? Now, before you get confused with. Before you get confused with the X, Y, and Z. Okay, I don't want you to get confused with the A, B, and C on top. Now, let's say I got three particles. The first particle is increasing. So, at zero time, all the distance is zero. We are talking about distance. Let's say X only. At X, this is 3, 6, 9, 12. What does it mean? The distance is increasing, but then the distance is increasing at a constant rate. Right? Every distance, every time, every second is increasing by 3. Okay? Now, second one. Still 0, but then I'm going like 2,
5,
6,
7,
12, 20. So you see, the change here is what? The change here is 2, the change here is 4, the change here is 6, the change here is 8. Do you see the increase is increasing? The rate of is increasing rapidly, right? Now the third one is 3.8. Is it increasing? Yes, right? It's still increasing, right? So this is the difference of 2, this is the difference of 1, this is difference of 0.5, this is difference of 0.3. All the three are increasing. Now, if I tell you, X, Y, and Z is actually represented by either the AB or this graph or this graph. What do you think X is? The first graph, second graph, or third graph?
Second
means increasing, but the rate is also increasing. Constant, right? So this X actually belongs to the first time. X actually belongs to first time, which is a straight line up one. Can you follow? Okay. Now the second one actually is Y. It's increasing, but at an alarming rate. Very rapidly. Every increase is so much more than the previous one. Can follow? Now the third one is still increasing. But every time it's getting slower and slower and slower. Can follow? Okay, so later you please watch the video and go and fill it in. Where do you write this? You should write this on the small book already. Do you want me the small book? Tomorrow weekend, okay? Then everything to be inside. Now back to question 5. So I try question 5 now. Now you know the story. So question 5. Now question 5, I try my best to draw. It looks something like that. And it looks something like that. Now I'm not going to go on to the detailed precise answer, but I'm going to show you how it looks like. So for example, I got time, I got height. Okay? Now the story say I change the story. This is empty. Still listening, huh? This is empty. What I want to do? I want to take water I want to pour in water. Understand the story?
Again, this is empty, and I want to pour in water. And what happened? When I pour water, what happened? The height will what? Go up or go down? Up, all the way up. Can you follow? Okay, now, first one. 7 cm. This is 7 cm. That means I can mark here 7
cm. Okay, I try. So, the first one, this thing here is 7. So what I do is very simple. 7 and this is time. I have a cross here. Now I ask myself,
if I pour water in, is the increase going to be getting slower and slower? Or is the increase going to be the same rate?
No.
Or the increase is going to be faster and faster?
Slower and slower because of the
force. Slower, faster and faster. So one must be correct. What do you think?
Same.
I got same. So three choose one. Out of the three,
after
one.
After the full
ready, let's look at the cross-sectional area.
Okay? Let's zoom in and look at the cross-sectional area. Ready? Okay, if I were to use a red line, I cut.
Hey, follow, important. Your message can go later. The cross-sectional here is big or small?
Small.
Is it filled up very quickly or filled up very slowly?
Yeah.
Fast, right? I call this tip to fill up very fast, right?
But as I go the next level, fast or slow?
Slow.
The next layer? Because why? I need to fill in more.
This cross-sectional area is small, right? So it will fill up slower. Agree? Assuming that the water rate is the same.
Then this one, fast or slow?
Slow.
This one?
Slow.
So you are talking about fast
to
slow. Now, if you tell me fast to slow, then you will tell me
the curve, is it going straight? That's a straight line? Or like that? Convex or concave?
Concave.
So that is how you draw.
So you're going to draw the line like that.
Can you follow? Now next one. Next one is 8 cm. So I cannot choose 8 here because 7 to 8 is only 1. I got to choose 8 cm. So 7 plus 8.
So the next one, if I can draw in black, the next one should be 15. So this thing here is the 8. So now I start. What do I look at? I always look at the cross-sectional area. So what's the cross-sectional area?
After filling up the hole,
is it
constant?
Faster to slower, slower to faster, or is it same?
Same,
right? So which means if I got a time here, I don't care what time this is, it should be a straight line. Can you follow? Can you suggest what is the last one? So this one is very big. Then what happened? Becoming smaller, right? So how do you draw?
Like
that.
Can follow? This can be used in all distance time graph, speed time graph can use. This can be used for all container, whether you are filling in or leaking out. Can follow? Okay. Any question?
If not, I stop the video here. Then you